Now that we have discussed what are attributes and how they can take values, let us discuss the types of attributes. The first type of attributes are simple attributes. Simple attributes are attributes which take on atomic values. By the term atomic, we mean that these values cannot be divided into two or more values. That is, say we have the attribute phone number. A phone number just has one part. Say, for example, the following phone number. It is atomic. It cannot be divided into two or more values. However, the second type is composite attributes. In composite attributes, we have two or more simple attributes. So, let us take the example of address. The address of a person can be broken down into room number 1, housing society, or say building, and street. So we can see that we have used three simple attributes, which are each atomic in nature, to form this composite attribute called address. Another example could be name, where we have first name and last name. So clearly, a composite attribute is an attribute which is composed of two or more simple attributes. The third type of attribute which we will be discussing is single valued attributes. Single valued attributes are those attributes which can just have one value. Now, you might be confused between simple and single valued. The difference is simple attributes cannot be broken down into sub attributes. However, when I say single valued attributes, they just have one value. They cannot be a list of values. If you want to store a list of values, we can use multi-valued attributes, which we'll be coming to soon. So single valued attributes are those which can just have one value associated with them. For example, the PAN card number of a person, it can just have one specific value, say something like this alphanumeric number. Whereas we can have the fourth type, which is multi-valued attributes. In a multi-valued attribute, you have a list of values instead of a single value. So consider the attribute email. So a person may have a primary email and a secondary email. Hence, when we make provisions for storing emails, we need to have a list of emails, like email 1, email 2, and so on. So this is an example of a multi-valued attribute. A similar example could be phone numbers. Most people today have more than one phone numbers. So we need to store a list of phone numbers. And these type of attributes will come under multi-valued attributes.